Hello. Today we're having one more lesson on decoupage on the woven items. Many people ask me how to make decoupage on woven items. Today I would like to show you the way I make it. In which way and with the help of which materials. So, here is a workpiece, an item we have to make decoupage on. The first condition is that I always make decoupage only on white items. There is also such an opinion that before making decoupage, one has to whiten the item, that is, to paint an item white and to make decoupage on it. But I personally think that though such a method has a right to exist, of course, but it takes more time. Actually, I haven't tried it, so I have nothing to say, but you have to know that such a variant does exist. I will show you the way I do it. When I weave, I try to fit the item to the pattern I will make decoupage of. Here I have decided to make decoupage of this three-layered handkerchief with apples on it. The motifs are large, so I decided to separate them, and where it was possible, I cut out the apples with leaves. I tried to make a white stripe corresponding to the height of the apple. So I have separated the motifs, cut out the apples with leaves. I don't want to stick up the whole stripe, so I will stick the apples with intervals of one pole. We will decorate the intervals with the leaves and check how it will look. For decoupage, we take a napkin and cut out the motifs from all the three layers of a napkin. We will separate the layers right before placing the picture onto the item, because it is much easier to cut all the three layers together. So, we have cut the motifs of the napkin. Then we mix PVA glue with water, approximately half and half. As a result, we get such a weak solution. There is another method, I've tried it once. Instead of school glue with water, mix varnish with water and spread it in the same way. Many weavers complain that white items on which decoupage has been glued on PVA with water turn yellow with time if it stays in the sun for a long time. I personally don't have such experience, because my woven items don't stay in the sun, because I sell and hand them out too fast, and I don't have a chance to watch them. And the second point is that I leave the bases white very seldom. You will see that I spread some paint on the background to make it either milky, or light green, or light yellow, sand-colored. It seems to me that it looks much more natural this way. So, we start. Take a motif. The napkin used to be three-layered, but while I was cutting it, one of the layers got separated, so I separate one more layer, and the only layer, the colored one, remains. I dip a brush into white glue mixed with water and spread the solution carefully from the center toward the edges. Got it? Then take the next motif. We have cut out various motifs, so we try to alternate them. There are three layers left here, we separate two of them. It seems even four layered. We leave some space for one leaf and spread the solution very carefully, especially carefully where the leaves are seen, from the center toward the edges. It is the way our pattern looks like. We have formed this colored border by ourselves. Sometimes I buy napkins with borders on them. Such napkins are very valuable for me, because for decoupage, flowers on white background is a very convenient, even priceless napkin. In this case, you don't have to cut every flower out, you can stick the whole stripe onto the item. Such a napkin. This one is not actually a border, but you can see a stripe here, so for some item, maybe a little higher one, it can match as well. Or such ones. You can divide them into motifs, or you can stick the whole stripe. The only disadvantage of such method is that in this case the weaving hides behind decoupage, while in our case one can see that it is decoupage on a woven item. We both have not hidden the woven item and at the same time decorated it. Now I offer you a stage, which is not necessary, but taking into account that the white part of the item with cool glue on it can turn yellow with time. And the second point is that not all the patterns look good on white backgrounds. That is why I want to make background the color of the napkin, light sand colored. We will kill two birds with one stone. First of all, in this case, I've done my best to cut the motifs out very carefully. But next time, if we paint the background, we will be able to cut them out not so thoroughly. I have found this advice on the site of Елена Пересторонина, babalena.ru, and I've liked it very much and started using it in my work. I take white acrylic paint. By the way, I've stopped throwing such trays away too. Not all of them, but some of them I have saved for myself. Meat and dried fruit get sold and such. It is very convenient to use them. You don't have to buy a special palette. So white paint, and you can also use built-in paint color, but it often behaves unpredictably and spreads. That's why I use it sometimes if I drop a little bit of it, but of course it is much better to use acrylic paint as paint. So a bit of yellow paint and a bit of brown one. And further we mix. Add a bit of yellow and a bit of brown and make a background. We will also drop a little water here. So I've prepared such a light sand colored, or rather baked milk colored mixture. And for decoupage, I use, as a rule, two brushes. Such a cut one, I slap paint with it. Here I have failed a little, so in this case we take a thinner brush to make the item neater. Both to keep the pattern of a leaf and to paint the background. Maybe in some parts I will have to rub out. Where there is more vacant space, you can slap paint with no fear. Where it doesn't get painted well between the tubes, you use a thinner brush again. I choose a brush corresponding to the circumstances. A regular sponge will not help here. Here the work is more delicate. It is impossible to paint all the gaps on woven perfectly. But, on the other side, decoupage on such sand-colored or milky background wouldn't be so expressive. That's why I've decided that it is better to make decoupage on white background and to tone it afterwards. And there is one more advantage of such toning. One can create different shades of colors. So if you want to, you can make it a little darker here and a bit lighter closer to the picture. There is enough space for your imagination. Here I had to wipe up with a dust and with a finger not to paint over a brown stripe. Later, when the acrylic paint dries out, I will varnish the surface, and I personally like the result I get. It is up to each of you, of course, to decide. Maybe it has some disadvantages, but it is the way I do it. Good luck to all of you!